And good evening, U.S. soccer fans, and welcome to Everbank Field here on the banks of the St. John's River in Jacksonville, Florida, as the U.S. women's national team takes on Scotland in a friendly and the first game for the women in this, the centennial year for U.S. soccer. It's the debut of head coach Tom Cermani, and it's against his native country of Scotland. And it's the first of two games here at the friendlies against Scotland, as they will meet Wednesday night in Nashville. Teams right now are taking their opportunity in the photos. They're getting the chance on the field. We'll give you the starting lineups for Scotland. In goal, Gemma Fay. She's also the captain. Number two, Rhonda Jones. Number three, Rachel Small. And number 10, Jennifer Beatty are the defensemen. In the midfield, Joanne Love. She wears number six. Haley Louder, number seven. Kim Little, number eight. And Leanne Crichton wears number 14. Jane Ross, she'll wear 13 playing up front alongside number 16, Lisa Evans, and number 18, Emma Mitchell. For the United States, a couple of new players, or at least a couple of players, getting an opportunity. And Jill Loydon will get her opportunity in net. It will be her sixth cap, as Jill will get the call. Hope Solo nursing a small calf injury. Shouldn't keep her out, but gives Jill an opportunity. On the back line, Kelly O'Hara. She wears number five. Christy Rampone, who is making her 277th cap, gets the start and wears the captain armband. Becky Sauerbrunn wears number four. She's next to her. And on the right side, it's the return of Allie Krieger. She'll be wearing number 11. Allie had knee surgery a year ago and getting her first chance to get back in. Heath Tobin wears number 17. She's on the left side of the midfield. In the middle, Shannon Box wears number 7, and Carly Lloyd will man that middle of the field for the U.S. Carly wears number 10. And it is the first cap for Kristen Press, who will be wearing number 22. She'll be on the right side. Very exciting moment for her. And, of course, up front, Abby Wambach wears number 20, who is making her 199th cap. She also is just six goals behind Mia Hamm. She'll be looking to get that here in the season here as these two games against Scotland, and then, of course, the Algarve Cup coming up next month. And number 13, Alex Morgan. Just a couple of seconds away from kickoff. Scotland wearing their blue jerseys. They're in their team huddle still. White shorts and red socks for the United States. Of course, the signature red and white hooped jerseys. They're blue shorts and white socks. The head coach for Scotland, Anna Sinuel, she will be out there just with a few subs. There will be six substitutes available for both teams today. We'll see if they're going to be utilized. I had a chance to talk with Tom Cermani beforehand, and obviously with his first game as the national team coach of the United States, he wants to see some of these veterans as they get ready for the games. He'd also like to see what some of these other players can do, and we would hope to be able to see many more subs. The U.S. will kick it off. They will be going from the south. That's the St. John's River back behind them, and Scotland will be defending the north end here in the first half. Wind is a nice night here on this early evening in Jacksonville, about 60 degrees, a little bit more so, as we hit this 5 o'clock kickoff, as Wambach will play it to Morgan, and they'll play it back. And the U.S. loses it, and Scotland will attack up the middle of the field. And it's a shot, but it's off the mark by number 6 for Scotland, Joanne Love, who was able to get the steal away from Shannon Box. But it will be a goal kick for the United States. As we mentioned, the wind is about 10 miles per hour. It'll be at the back of the Scotland team here in the first half. So Loydon will play it short. Out to Box, and then, of course, up to O'Hara. Looks forward. And Tobin will play it on for an on-running Alex Morgan, who plays it into the box, onto her left foot, cuts it across, open shot! Save off the line by the defenseman for Scotland. That was Haley Louder who made that save. And the second head ball collected by the goalkeeper, Gemma Fay, in the U.S. Very dangerous in the opening minute. Scotland will play it out, and it'll be a throw-in for the United States. U.S. women taking advantage of that opportunity early on to put some early pressure on Scotland, but not able to capitalize with the goal. Allie Krieger with the throw. Looks up. Kristen Press plays that one out of bounds. It'll be a Scotland throw. Good crowd here in Jacksonville tonight for this friendly. Long ball by Scotland. Taken by the back line for the U.S. and be played back to Lloyden. Sauerbrunn. As they try and find Wambach, ball skips past. And now Scotland will take it just in the United States half. Ball controlled along the back line for the U.S. That's Sauerbrunn. Back into Rampone. O'Hara inside. U.S. gets it back as Morgan gets it. On it is Lloyd. And O'Hara will play it back to Sauerbrunn. Sauerbrunn's pass intercepted by Scotland. They get a little bit of a counter, but the United States behind the ball pretty good and forces Scotland to retreat into their own half. Joanne Love has it for Scotland. Played 3 minutes. The U.S. with a dangerous opportunity. Now gets a steal. And it's Wambach coming towards net. Tries to play it in to press. It's intercepted. Wambach can't get it back. And now Scotland will come out of their end. Ball played by Lauder. Inside. The ball's going to find its way to Lloyden, who comes outside of her box and just sends it towards midfield. U.S. will keep it on the back line and give it back to Lloyden, who has it at her feet. She'll take her time, send everyone forward, and ask Krieger to come back, so she'll give it her on the right side. O'Hara and Sauerbrunn working together. Now back again to Lloyden. Long ball looked forward. Wambach chested down. Heath Tobin comes and gets the interception. She'll attack. Tobin Heath. Ball played in to the box. Trapped down, but lost by the U.S. And Scotland will come out of their end. Back again, that's Crichton. Up ahead to Love. Love has it again for Scotland. The United States, as we mentioned, Tom Sermani, his first opportunity to see his women's team in a competitive game. They've had training camp all week. As the ball is played forward for Abby Wambach. She'll take it into the corner. She'll try and go around the defender, but she cannot do it. She's going to be called for the foul. A Scotland free kick just outside their penalty area. They're going to let Jim Maffei come out and take it. Maffei wearing the captain's armband. Sends it to the forwards, challenged, and it will roll across, and Lloyden gets it again for the U.S., and she'll just play it out. Tobin Heath able to keep it in. She'll use her left back, O'Hara. The United States will try and switch the field. They'll bring it across slowly. Box to Sauerbrunn to Rampone. Again, Christy Rampone looks forward. It's at Wambach. She brings it down. Can't connect with Morgan, and the U.S. turns it over, but it'll go off of the U.S. for a Scotland throw-in. Right about midfield, we've played 6.5 minutes. It is scoreless. welcome to everyone watching us on USSoccer.com. Krieger under pressure. Very well, gets it out. Now it's at the feet of Carly Lloyd. Lloyd gets it back. She'll look forward, and it's intercepted. And it's going to go out, and it'll be a throw-in at midfield for the United States. The women's team off to a victory tour. Last played in a game back on December 15th in Florida, as a matter of fact, a 4-1 win over the China People's Republic. Alex Morgan down to the line. She's going to cross it back with the left foot again. Dangerous, and is cleared out by Scotland and now sent upfield. And the United States will keep possession. Krieger up to Christy Press on the right side. She'll take it down to the end line. She'll cross it. Doesn't get there. Scotland able to clear it out, but still pressure. Now free in the box, and Abby Wambach sends it across, and Scotland sends it out, and it will be a throw-in for the United States. Krieger to take it. Again, we mentioned Allie Krieger with her first game back since her knee surgery. Finds the feet of Christy Press. Now out, sent across. Dummied there by the U.S., but it's still free. Now to the feet of Lloyd, who scored two goals in the Olympic final. Ball played to Lloyd. She's on a nice run. Down on her left foot, she'll send it across over the goal, and it'll be a goal kick for Scotland. U.S. with good pressure there, but not able to get the ball across. So Jim Fay will have the goal kick. Wind at the back of Scotland here in the first half. Very nice night here in Jacksonville, Florida. Abby gives a short to Tobin Heath. She'll take a left-footed shot from distance, and it will go out for a goal kick. Headed on, and Carly Lloyd will chase it down. She'll get it out to Krieger, is gonna run up the side, but she's cut off, so she'll play it in, and it's an intercepted pass for Scotland. But the U.S. will get it back. Now wide to Tobin Heath, but it doesn't get there, and Scotland will take it. Collision there, but the United States will come up with the ball. Through ball intercepted by the U.S., but Scotland gets it back. 30 yards out, they'll try and take it away by Box. Alex Morgan able to get to the ball, but should be called for the foul. Free kick just inside the half, and the injured Scotland player has taken an extra second. She's on her feet now. That's Rhonda Jones, one of the defenders. Beatty will play it forward. It's going to roll back towards Jill Lloyden, who will control it with her feet. Finds Krieger wide. Sauerbrunn to O'Hara. United States keeping possession. Tobin Heath will have it, and we'll have the Alex Morgan tied up a bit, and Rhonda Jones, who was taken down by Alex Morgan, says that was for that. This one was Joanne Love and Alex Morgan tied up. Tobin Heath will send it across. It's headed away by Scotland. Top of the box, and now Christy Press has it. Press is going to have to go back towards midfield, keep possession with Rampone, and then we'll continue. U.S. has advantage, but with the fouls going on, the referee blows that one. It'll be a free kick for the United States. That one's down to the top of the box. Shot. Goal! Christy Press with a left-footed shot, and the United States has a 1-0 lead. And Christy Press's first cap. She gets her first goal. What a memory for Kristen Press as the United States takes the 1-0 lead. Ball was headed away by Scotland, but it came down to her standing right at the top of the 18, touched it one time and put it in the upper corner. Now Rampone will play it back to Lloyden in Scotland. Takes the ball. Be a throw in for Scotland. And another throw for Scotland. One goes off of Scotland. The United States will have it. Is Press able to play it off with the Scottish defender? Wambach heads it back down. This is going to come to the feet of Morgan. Alex Morgan will try and play it through for Wambach, who will run on. One on one with the defender. She's in the penalty area, and the defender will slide and play it out. That was Beatty for Scotland, but Wambach runs over, gets it quickly. Now towards the chest of Press. She'll lose it there, and Rampone's going to have to play it short. She and Sauerbrunn will work the two-man game. Now to Shannon Box. Up to O'Hara, the U.S. keeping it with Carly Lloyd. Rampone will look to see if Press can get by the defender. She's got one-on-one out wide. She'll try and go around her. Lauder does a good job and will play it out of bounds, and it will be a throw in the U.S. Krieger, quick throw. Back to Krieger. Off the right foot, she'll send it across off the defender of Scotland, and another throw deep into Scotland in. Short to Morgan. Morgan able to turn, but the defender will get to it beforehand, and now Scotland will get it, but the United States again. Well, it takes it away for a moment, but Scotland will get a chance to attack again. To the feet of Wambach. Touched. Tobin Heath tries to find Morgan. And Gemma Faye will come off her line to get that one before the dangerous U.S. forward can get there. But Shannon Box works hard to get that steal in the Scotland end, but it's going to go off of Box, and it'll be a throw in for Scotland. Well read by Sauerbrunn, but her header can't get to Wambach or make that Morgan. Ball will roll back to Gemma Faye again. United States leads 1-0 on Kristen Press, her first goal and her first cap for the United States. Thank you. goes over Wambach, but now it comes to Morgan. Defense for Scotland able to get there quickly, but they'll turn it over as well. Krieger. That one's cleared away. But Box will work hard to get it for the U.S. There's O'Hara. And just possession for the United States. So O'Hara, who's taken down, able to push the ball past it, but foul committed by Scotland. It'll be a free kick for the United States. Here's Tobin Heath, who has that left foot. I ask her to push it back a few yards. Headed on by Wambach. It's still up free. Running onto it. And now just a touch wide was Kristen Press. Once again, dangerous for Press. Able to get in, but no angle. And that one goes out for a goal kick for Scotland. There's Kristen Press. It was impressing here in game one for her. Headed up, foul called on the U.S. Carly Lloyd called for that one. Rhonda Jones over the ball for Scotland. Just inside her own half. Referee tells her to play it along. She does, and that one's brought down, controlled by the U.S. Heath can't get with Alex Morgan. Morgan will be called for a foul. This one actually just now was an offside. That played in towards the corner. Hit the corner flag, but just barely rolled over the line. But it would be a free kick for the United States. Some of the fans here in Jacksonville, as Lloyden will come up well off her line, plays the long ball looking for Morgan. Flicks it on, tries to connect with Press, but it doesn't. Second ball will find its way to Shannon Box, and the U.S. again keeps possession along the back line, although a little dangerous by Rampone, but she's able to get it to Lloyden. Up to Sauerbrunn, out wide to O'Hara. O'Hara's pass deflected back to Sauerbrunn again, and they'll try it over with Lloyden. Jill Lloyden with her fifth cap, getting time. Head to Wambach. She'll send it to Morgan. Free kick for Scotland. Over the top. And it's a dangerous opportunity and flicked on and over for Scotland. That was Lisa Evans, who got behind the U.S. defense and with Lloyden out a bit. But it was well over the net, as Lloyden will take this goal kick. A couple of the fans here at Everbank Field in Jacksonville. No handballs. Did go off the arm, but it was still by the side. And now Scotland, one-on-one on the back line. Rampone able to cut her off. This one sent across by Evans. Headed away by O'Hara. Tobin Heath gets it and back to O'Hara. And it's going to go out of bounds on the long ball. So the throw-in will be for Scotland. go off the United States, and it'll be a throw-in against Scotland. Rampone up to Wambach. Tobin Heath, it's a fancy work, but keeps possession. And now Rampone will send it wide to Krieger. Alley inside. Taken down is Carly Lloyd, and it'll be a free kick for the U.S. Inside of 35 yards. Like a three-man wall for Scotland. All flipped into the area and down on the foot. And Abby Wambach just about had goal number 153. She's six behind Mia Hamm. That one came down onto her left foot and just rolled over it. And it's a goal kick for Scotland. Wambach able to get that one. Cannot connect with Morgan as Carly Lloyd tried to flip it on. Scotland will bring it out of their own half. Long ball. Looking for Jane Ross as she runs on to it. And it will go off of Ross. It will be a goal kick for the U.S. Over halfway here in the first half. The United States leading 1-0. Delay as the ball rolled onto the field. The old ball out of play. And now Lloyden will take the goal kick. Beatty for Scotland. With some good moves. And now coming in one-on-one into the penalty area. It's flipped on, saved by Jemma Fay. Scotland has it. It's Carly Lloyd who had that opportunity, and now it'll be a free kick for the United States as Kristen Press just about got into the penalty area, and it'll be called just outside, and a dangerous opportunity for the U.S. Take a few steps, the four-man wall here for it. It's that bit of an angle. One shot to curl around, and it's just in the side netting. It's just wide on that free kick taken by Carly Lloyd. Tobin Heath has it in front of the Scotland bench, and this one just skips off her foot. It'll be a throw-in for Scotland. This one will be off of Abby. She disagrees with it, but Scotland will take the quick throw. Inside to Abby, and the tackle by Scotland sends it wide. But with the step over is Carly Lloyd. She'll bring it back towards the middle. She'll play it towards the back post. There's Kristen Press. She cannot connect with Alex Morgan before Scotland clears it out for a throw-in. Press in the corner. Sent across. And now it's to the left foot. Looks like Lloyd, she can't line it up. And now cleared away by Scotland. O'Hara. Working short with Box. Now wide to Krieger. A little bit of space. Is she onside? She is. Scotland looking for a call. They don't get it. Wamba. Able to keep it in play, but the U.S. has to go back towards midfield. Keeping possession. Cut it inside to Krieger. Into Tobin Heath. Now press. Will turn. Will look wide. And the tackle will go out, and it will be a corner kick for the United States. Alex Morgan able to create that corner. This will be taken by Press. Sends it in. Over the head of Abbey, but the ball is still free. Now to the left foot shot, and it's going to go over the bar. That was Allie Krieger, who was able to get that one from about 25 yards out, but send it high. So Faye's goal kick for Scotland. A little push off by Box, and it'll be a free kick for Scotland. The U.S. and Scotland have played only one other time. That was 10 years ago. This one's going to go off of Box. It was an 8-2 victory at the Columbus Crew Stadium back on September 8, 2002. Ironically, one, there were two hat tricks in that game. One of them by number 20, Abby Rombaugh here. Mia Hamm, of course, had the other one. Good pressure there by Lloyd, but Scotland able to get pressure and maintain the ball. Tried to play into the box, and Christy Rampone, as she's done so many times in her career, able to take that one away. Lloyd under a little bit of pressure, so she'll send it forward, but Scotland will get the long ball out. But the U.S. just can't go. It seems to find the foot of Scotland player until now. Now up to Alex Morgan. She'll lose it at midfield. Controlled by Beatty for Scotland. Sent across. This hit, and this one's going to find its way to Jim Afay. Looking for Abby Wamba. Again, the U.S. a good job of maintaining possession. Now, Tobin Heath. Left foot across. Running on to it is Press. A header and a goal! Again, Kristen Press! With their second goal, and the U.S. leads 2-0. Well, the long ball by Heath as she took it out, and she's been dangerous with the left foot all game. Able to send it across. Kristen Press on the back post does exactly what you're asked. And the young lady now has her second goal. You put it back where it came from. And that's what she did. absolutely perfectly executed by the United States. And now lead Scotland 2-0. Well, Press playing the unusual position of right midfield for her. She's a forward. But when you have an Abby Wambaugh and an Alex Morgan, you want to get this young lady in, and she's showing why. Here in her first start. Scotland goes forward, but the United States able to take it away in the corner. Tom Sermani looking pretty good, making a couple of these decisions in his first chance as the men's national team head coach. Make it the women's national team head coach as the man. This is a free kick for the United States as Abby Wambaugh is taken down. US keeps it along the back line. It's Rampone. Played out by Scotland. A 2-0 lead. Two goals by Kristen Press. As the shadows here at Everbank Field are off the field, still some of the stands on the east side. It's Tobin Heath working with O'Hara. Shannon Box will play it off of the Scotland player. She's looking for Wambach. Throw in O'Hara. Tobin Heath, a nice run. She comes to it. Now it's at the feet of Alex Morgan. Top of the box. Morgan will play it back. That's Carly Lloyd. Out again to Alex Morgan. Onto her foot, around the defender. Takes a left-footed shot, blocked, and it's now cleared away. Will it go out? No. Morgan will run to it, but now Scotland plays it off, and they're going to play it off of Alex Morgan. It'll be a throw-in for Scotland. Morgan doesn't agree with it, but it's a throw-in for Scotland. Neither do the fans. Play forward, that's Kim Little. And that's going to be a handball on the U.S. Free kick for Scotland. Line held just outside the penalty area. Away by Wambach, who goes back to the defensive line. Her ability in the air to win those. Tackled away by Tobin Heath. It'll be a throw-in for Scotland. Good pressure by the U.S. They'll get the steals. Wambach back again from her forward position. There's two Scotland players, and the United States able to clear that one away. It could be Rampone or Krieger. Got that opportunity, and now Rampone does a good job of shielding the Scotland defender to allow Jill Lloyden to come out and collect that one with her hands. Rampone and Krieger working together on that right side. Now up to Lloyd into box. Wambach at her feet, able to turn. Step over by Morgan out to Press. Kristen Press. Plays it on the back side, and that one cannot connect with Heath. And that one is going to be a free kick for Scotland. Beatty will take it for Scotland inside their own center circle, looking wide. Tries to find Emma Mitchell. She's got it, being defended on the far side. Tries to cut it in. Can't get it across. A good job of defending by the U.S. Lombok at her feet at midfield. Morgan running on to it. She'll try and get it into her, but it does not. It's too far, and Faye will get it. Faye runs out quickly, but nothing is there, so she'll send them forward. Headed away by Sauerbrunn. Now cleared away by Faye. As we mentioned, six subs for each team in this friendly. Quite a few bodies are getting warm on the sideline, both teams. Tobin Heath, two defenders on her. She'll lose it. O'Hara, who'd come over, but dribbling out of bounds, is Emma Mitchell, and it'll be a throw in for the U.S. Tobin Heath will get called for the foul. Tackle from behind, free kick for Scotland. Rachel Small stands over this one as Scotland sends their players to the 18-yard box. U.S. with everyone behind the ball towards the penalty spot. Lloyd and out, no man's land, headed away by the U.S. And Alex Morgan, who cuts it back, gets taken down. Foul called here on Joanne Love. Morgan had the ankle stepped on. Love will earn the yellow card. Assistants asked for that. As we mentioned, this training camp here has a little bit of extra significance as well, as Tom Sermani, he'll have this game and the game on Wednesday, along with the practices in between, to evaluate the players, to choose the roster for the 2013 Algarve Cup in Portugal, running the 6th through the 13th of March. Of course, the United States in those games will face Iceland on the 6th, People's Republic of China on the 8th, and Sweden on the 11th. As Morgan is still down. Say that, she's getting up. It looked like maybe the left ankle was stepped on here on the replay. We'll get a look at that. And she came across, and it was the left ankle that was stepped on. Earned Love a yellow card for Scotland, but not a lot of pressure put on that, and actually none. She's being assisted off the field. That's Alex Morgan, who is being carried off. Kristen Press, the 17th player for the United States to score in their first cap. She has both goals for the United States. No one has ever gotten a hat trick in their first cap, but there have been two others to score too. She is the third one in the history for the U.S. And Morgan made her way over to the bench, and looks like we will have a substitution for the U.S. as Sydney LaRue will come on for Alex Morgan. But you have to hope that Morgan's okay. She did not put any pressure on that ankle as she came across, and it was stepped on. But LaRue in the 41st minute for the United States. So back to action. As this ball played in toward the corner, and LaRue will get her first touch on it. She'll play it back. Tobin Heath steps over and knocked to O'Hara. Now we'll get it to Heath in the overlapping run, and Heath has to cut inside, and she is still on sides. Ball played across, headed down, but not away, and Scotland does get the second ball out. Good ball there by O'Hara on the overlapping run. Rampone will work it with Krieger. There's Press. Now Rampone looking to switch the field. Box will have it, and a turnover there. Scotland now will attack. It's Jane Ross. She has about one or two touches too many, and the U.S. will take it away from her. Taken down now. Looked to be maybe Allie Krieger. No, was not. Maybe Carly Lloyd. The U.S. will play it short. So O'Hara. Good move, and now into Wamba. Abby's left foot across is just going to go to Jim Effet. For Scotland, earned a throw in right in front of the U.S. bench. That one's cleared away, another throw in for Scotland. This will go out for a goal kick. Final couple minutes on the clock here in the first half. They have a little extra stoppage time. United States on two goals by Kristen Press. Tobin Heath cuts inside. LaRue back out to O'Hara. Tobin Heath again looking to get this one across, but she'll play it in to Wambach. Has it at her feet. She dribbles to the corner and can't control it. It'll be a throw in Scotland deep in the area, deep inside their own end. United States will try and pinch them in on this throw in. Not a lot of Scotland players helping her right now. Headed down, Shannon Box. And back to Lloyd. There will be 2 minutes stoppage time here in the first half. Scotland with a dangerous opportunity in the last minute. Ball played shortly and cleared out by Rampone. Press back to Krieger. So it'll be sent out wide for the U.S. O'Hara gets up to midfield. Turn over there, Scotland will turn it right back over. Sauerbrunn and Rampone work in the back line. Box had that one blocked, and she'll run back and chase it. And the U.S. again along the back line. Again, the two-goal lead here on both goals by Press. O'Hara into Wambach. O'Hara able to get around the defender. It's on her left foot. She's looking to cross it. Tackled by Scotland's Rhonda Jones. And Jones will dribble out to thwart that U.S. attack. Long ball. Sauerbrunn will be the first one to it. She'll get it to Lloyden, the referee. looking at her watch. And that will be the first half whistle. Well, overall, very memorable start here in Tom Sermani's first game as the U.S. national team coach for the women as they get a 2 goals from their young player, Kristen Press, and the U.S. leads 2-0 as we head to the half on USsoccer.com. Second half action underway here at Everbank Field. The United States leading Scotland 2-0. Appears to be the only sub as the U.S. attacks forward here. This is Carly Lloyd. Gets to the penalty area, and Scotland able to cut that run off. And Krieger's going to try and run it down. She'll have a throw in. But the United States will substitute. Nicole Barnhart will come in for Jill Lloyden on the first half. This one's out of bounds. Be a throw in for Scotland. Trying to see any other confirmation of numbers for either team. We do know that. Wambach up front. So he only substitute, that is the second substitute for the United States. As we mentioned, Alex Morgan left with an injury in the first half. She was stepped on. And Sydney LaRue came in for her. Try and get the status of Morgan. As Krieger will work with Rampone. Over to Sauerbrunn. Shannon Box playing the defensive midfield position. Again, back towards Rampone. Looks forward for press. Turn. Wambach able to do an empty move. And the possession maintained by the United States. LaRue sends it across. This one's intercepted by Scotland. And it will make its way back to Nicole Barnhart. First game of two. Wednesday night, same two teams from Nashville. You can also catch that one on ussoccer.com. It's Carly Lloyd as this one taken off her foot. A good pressure by LaRue, able to at least win it back for the U.S. for a second. Now Kristen Press with a left-footed goal in the first few minutes of the game and a header. For a goal a little bit later to give the U.S. their 2-0 lead. She earns the free kick in the United States. Look as Rampone will try and get it to Krieger. Krieger, defender on, she'll push it towards the corner. Right foot, cross. Goal box, trapped down, it's free. Now it's loose and Lloyd will have it and it's a free kick. It'll be called on the United States, the foul. As that ball came down to Abby Wambach, who's had it on the left foot. Just ended up trapping it there. Great ball across by Krieger. But it will be a free kick for Scotland. It's Gemma Fay for her second half of action. That one goes off of Scotland. Doesn't appear any substitutions for Scotland. It's Tobin Heath inside. Shannon Box with a step over and it will find its way out to Krieger again. Wide ball waiting on the sideline, O'Hara. She and Heath work together. The United States again sends it back towards her midfield stripe, again keeping possession. Looking to break down the Scotland defense. Stepping inside, that's Rampone. Midfielder's showing, but they'll send it wide to Krieger. Alley gets it to Tobin Heath. She'll get it back. Now wide again on the overlapping run by Krieger. She'll send it across with the left foot. Top of the penalty area. LaRue dummies it. Out wide. Now back across. And that one's on Shannon Box's foot. Now it's come in to Tobin Heath and her right foot shot sails over the crossbar. Goal kick for Scotland. Just about 5 minutes gone here in the second half. free kick. His challenge by the U.S. player was a little too physical on Scotland. And the U.S. with the free kick. Now out to Carly Lloyd on the right side. She'll cut it back inside. Looks to cross it. Left foot back post. No one there, and it's going to be run down by the United States. That's Wambach. Heath into the area. Now tries left foot, Carly Lloyd into the corner, and now Scotland will just push it out. Corner kick, United States. So good pressure here by the United States last minute or so, but no shots on net, but it will earn a corner kick here. Corner kick taken by the U.S. Low, driven out by Scotland, and it's going to be a throw-in. Injury update on Alex Morgan. Officially a hard knock onto the left ankle. She'll be evaluated after the game. Again, she came out in the last 5 minutes of the first half after getting stepped on. And just precautionary right now, and they'll want to keep a better eye on that. O'Hara, left foot. It's on two. Press onto Shannon Box, sets it down, right foot shot, goal! A cracker of a shot from Shannon Box from about 25 yards out, and the United States leads 3-0. Ball came down to her. She played it really well with the outside of her right foot and then able to half volley it into the upper corner. And the U.S. with a 3-goal lead here in Jacksonville. Barnhart under pressure. She's just going to send it towards midfield. Hera tries to play it up the sideline, and it will go out of bounds and thrown in for Scotland. So two first half goals by Kristen Press. And now a second half goal by Shannon Box. That's where we stand. 3-0 United States women's national team in Tom Sermani's debut as the women's national team coach. As the U.S. called for a foul. Top of the penalty area. This ball's going to roll free, chase down. Carly Lloyd, it's turned by the Scotland player. Sent across, it's still free. Free ball, top of the box, shot ripped, and it's a goal. Scotland. Ball rolled free, and Kim Little was able to bury it 16 yards out into the net, and Scotland's on the board. United States leads 3-1. As the ball rolled free, it was sent out. It was cleared out by the U.S., but as Little able to come on and one-time it from the top of the penalty area at the 18-yard box, and was able to put it in the top corner, and it's 3-1. Abby Wambach will come off this in her 199th cap. She's going to be replaced by Lauren Chaney. So Abby Wambach not able to inch closer to Mia Hamm. Still 6 goals behind. That'll be something that U.S. soccer fans will keep their eyes on all year to become the all-time leading scorer. She's also second in all-time points, but only 1 point off of that number. But did not get the goal today. This one's kept in. It's kept in their own area. As Barnhart has to run well out of her box, just send it across the sideline. A throw in for Scotland. Boyd will look forward for LaRue. Barnhart comes outside of her penalty area, touches it shortly to Sauerbrunn. So the U.S. with their third sub of the game. And Krieger has it along the sideline. Allie Krieger getting her first action since her reconstructive knee surgery a year ago. Played forward, Tobin Heath has it on her feet. She'll play it to Shannon Box. Into Carly Lloyd. She'll turn. Left foot shot top of the area, and it's collected by Gemma Fay. Not a lot on it, but a great move to get that shot. And Scotland will come out from their end. Headed away by the United States. Throw in for Scotland. Well, the U.S. took the 3-0 lead and then gave up a goal. A little bit of misfortune, and the bounce rolled right for Scotland, and well finished by Little for a team from across the Atlantic. Onsides for Scotland behind the defense. Now down the sideline, played across, headed away. Good wrestle by Rampone, but now it's free and it's sent over the crossbar by Joanne Love for Scotland. Scotland, after that last goal, a little energized. A couple more opportunities here in the U.S. end. It is still a 3-1 lead. Ball played short. Barnhart will have it at her feet again. Barnhart waiting on an action. This is Barnhart's 47th cap. Not getting the start. Solo nursing a slightly strained left calf. Very slightly strained. But wanting to rest and maybe see what Lloyden and Barnhart could do today. U.S. with possession. And onsides is LaRue. LaRue is behind the defender. She's into the penalty area. Brings it across, waiting on a runner. It's at the feet. It's Kristen Press. She turns from the top of the area looking for her third goal shot. Save! Gemma Fay able to make that save. And in the ensuing action, Fay able to cover up. But Kristen Press with an opportunity for the hat trick there, but wasn't able to get it, but did get a great shot off and a nice save by Fay. So half of the substitutions used by the United States. We expect to see them all. I had a chance to talk with Tom Shimani before the game. And Scotland again, dangerous. Dribble into the area and sends it far post. This time, it was Lisa Evans able to get behind the defense and kind of a cross shot that wasn't on net and wasn't to a head. The U.S. will take the goal kick at it. As I mentioned to Tom Shimani, we talked to him before the game, was hoping to get a good look at six plays. You just never know what the conditions of the game are going to bring. It is a friendly, as LaRue will get it and send it wide out to Tobin Heath. Heath, one-on-one with the defender, brings it inside onto the right foot. Now she's going to try and find one of her teammates, but it's cleared away by Scotland. One ball played up, chested down by Ross. She's got no help, but running on to it now is the goal scorer Little for Scotland. Ross has it roll over her foot and into the hands of Barnhart. She'll play it up the other side as Krieger will get an opportunity. She'll drive towards midfield. Cannot connect her pass up with freshly on Lauren Cheney. This one goes too far for Scotland again. Barnhart has it at her feet. Gemma Fay brings it down in her penalty area. U.S. currently ranked number one in the world in the FIFA rankings. Scotland is 23rd. The U.S. will attack more. They'll send it wide and Krieger has to run it down. She does. Alley down the sideline. Nice move in. Nice pass up towards Press. Press cannot connect with Krieger, who's making the run inside again. This is going to go off of the U.S. and the Scotland throw. Pass by Scotland. Sees Cheney with it at her feet. Now Heath into LaRue. LaRue behind the defender. She's got one to beat the goalkeeper. She plays it back and running on to it is Press. Can't get there and Box will take a shot. A miscommunication as Kristen Press may have had an opportunity but a little bit of a collision with the teammate. May have seen history averted at that point. Press already scoring two. We've seen two U.S. players in the past scored two goals in their first cap. No one's yet to score a hat trick, and with two goals tonight for Press, looking for that opportunity, as is the goal kick by Scotland, is controlled by the United States. Scotland will steal it from the United States on the backside. Scotland, another dangerous run. To the outside, left foot shot right at Barnhart and controls it nicely. As Scotland looking to cut this game to a one goal as Emma Mitchell. It's off a shot, but again, Barnhart, good position. Unable to make that save. And Barnhart now, I'll make that Emma Mitchell, is called for a foul. Lloyd in box, they'll play it out to O'Hara. Scotland ready to make their first sub of the game. Looks like Leanne Ross will be coming on at that moment. Spin move by Cheney. Now Press. Press in the corner of the penalty area. Cuts it inside. Looks. There's Tobin Heath. Tobin misses communication, but Box will get it. She'll try and keep it out. Krieger's not going to be able to chase this one down. We'll have a throw in for Scotland. And we'll have a substitution. On to the game, as we mentioned, number five. Off to the game is Leanne Crichton, midfielder. Coming up on the 64th minute. The United States leads 3-1. Two goals by Kristen Press in her debut, one by Shannon Box, is what's gotten the United States on the scoreboard. Had a 3-0 lead. And then Kim Little able to get one back for Scotland. This one sent across by the right foot of Press, headed away at the penalty area, but Shannon Box is there again for the United States. You might be wondering where Megan Rapinoe is tonight. She only had one training after coming over from her club in France. And with that one training, just not enough to get on the field. She didn't suit as the 18, but that might change on Wednesday. Scotland able to take it away in the midfield, and they will counter. New sub Ross on the field. Her first touch. She'll play it back now, trying to get on it. Scotland another run, but it's like this time, captain Christy Rampone is there, but Christy looks upfield and it goes off her foot. Now we'll see the fourth sub of the United States. Nayel Averbush is on. She's going to come on for Shannon Box. So Averbush on for Box. And a throw in for Scotland. Good job by Allie Krieger. They're playing that one off the Scottish defender. It'll be a goal kick. The U.S. will play this one short again. The back is at the wind is at the back of the United States here in the second half, but they are maintaining possession, playing it too much through the air forward. This one will go off as Press tries to get it inside the chain. United States still have three people they could sub. Heather O'Reilly, Christy Mewis, and Julie Johnston, who would be getting her first cap, perhaps, fresh off the under 20 team at the World Cup this last year. As this one's dribbled out of bounds by Scotland, but they only have two more subs, so we'll keep our eyes on which player might be coming in. Krieger looking forward, running on to its Cheney. Cheney got there second after the Scotland player, but the Scotland player sends it out of bounds and it will be a throw-in for the U.S. Into Cheney, on it, in the penalty area. No help, she'll play it back out to Krieger. Krieger sends it across, headed away by Scotland, but not out. Now the ripped shot, high and over the top. That was O'Hara from her left back position, and it'll be a goal kick for Scotland. Sauerbrunn brings it down. Turton Heath chested down now. Cheney has it taken from her. Scotland with the free ball at midfield. Their substitute on. It's Leanne Ross who will send it across. Barnhart, first one, runs out to get it. She'll play it quickly. Out. That's Averbush. Averbush working together. Averbush just on for Shannon Box a couple of minutes ago. Now from that left midfield position, Tobin Heath all the way across the field. Get it overlapped by Cheney and she'll cut it back. Left foot looking. Not there. Averbush now tries to go and that pass is going to be intercepted. With some numbers on the far side, overlapping run. Sauerbrunn on the defense there. And she's going to force that ball out over the sideline. Good job of defending by Sauerbrunn. Barnhart with the goal kick. Short. Krieger working with Heath, now playing on that right midfield side. At least for the moment, as she makes her way back out to the left side. There's O'Hara into Heath. Kristen Press. Maybe getting an opportunity to push forward a little bit. Chaney going into the midfield. On the ball is Tobin Heath. She'll look to send this one in the penalty area. Of course, Abby Wambach has come off the field. They're usually the target on all these headers. This one sent into the penalty area. Goal box area. Jenna Fay has to get it. No U.S. player can get there before she does as the Scotland keeper collects it. Haverbush and Sauerbrunn working together. Flipped on just over Lauren Chaney, and she's in an offside position. And that will be the call. Looks like we'll have a substitution. No, he cannot, though, on the offsides. Looks like the United States and Scotland will both be making multiple substitutions, and I guess they will now. First for the U.S. coming off is Kristen Press, who will finish with two goals, and she will make her way off. What a debut for the young lady from California. Onto the field for Scotland is Ailish McSorley. She'll be on for Jennifer Beatty. And a final substitution for Scotland will be Suzanne Malone, who will be coming on for Emma Mitchell. So a couple of subs for Scotland and one for the U.S. The U.S. with one left. And if the other one of the two young ladies comes on, it'll either be Heather O'Reilly or Julie Johnston. O'Reilly with 179 caps in her career. Julie Johnston has yet to have one. Keep our eyes on that as Scotland takes a throw. And it's cleared out by the U.S. Scotland with possession in midfield. Good pressure by the U.S. Able to turn now, Scotland, but they'll get the turnover. Tobin Heath will look. She's played it over the top looking for Chaney. Chaney can't get there. Cleared wide, but Heath will run down. Perhaps she'll run down to it to take the throw in. She'll get it in. That's Chaney. Chaney along the goal line. Cannot turn, and Gemma Fay dives on it as she was being obstructed. Not obstructed, but perhaps shielded by the ball by the Scotland defender. That was Rhonda Jones. Good job of defending by Scotland. It's 3-1. United States leads Scotland. We mentioned same two teams on Wednesday night. Again, could be heard on ussoccer.com and watched. Ball played forward. And it will be a free kick for the United States. Standing over to Haverbush. 35, 40 yards out. Haverbush, a four-man wall here for Scotland. Lot on the back post. Krieger with an overlapping run on the right side, but Averbush will take a big right-footed shot off the crossbar. She ripped it from 35, and it doesn't go in, and the United States will chase it down wide, and they'll run back just to keep possession. What a shot by Averbush, but just about inches too high, and it came off the bar, back into play. Now Krieger will have it. She and Rampone. Up now to Tobin Heath. Back to Heath from Carly Lloyd. Heath tries to get it to Lloyd, doesn't get it. And now Scotland will have it. Ball played, a long run, and now United States on defense and in retreat. Taking a long shot as that Scottish player who was just on, or actually that was Jane Ross, had to run a long way, and a goal kick for Barnhart. Fans tonight, you are making history as part of the largest crowd to see the U.S. Women's National Team and a standalone friendly match in the entire Southeast United States. 18,656. U.S. Soccer, Everbank Field in the city of Jacksonville, thank you for your support. As the U.S., who has been dangerous and almost made this a 4-1 lead just moments ago. 18,656 in this friendly tonight here in Jacksonville. A great job by the fans. And that one's sent out of bounds for a throw in the United States. Krieger can't connect. Scotland will play that one out. Now Scotland brings it out of their own third towards midfield. And a foul will be called on the U.S. That was Sauerbrunn coming in late. One played across. He's going to go out of bounds on Scotland. The United States with the current 23-game overall unbeaten streak dating back to last year. They're 20-0-3 in those games, and with a 3-1 lead here in the final 12 to 13 minutes plus any injury time, I'd like to see that streak continue. This one played into the box, shielded off and well defended by Christy Rampone, to allow Nicole Barnhart to come out. She'll throw it out to Tobin Heath. Gets it, and she'll work with Krieger on the near sideline. Played wide. Tobin Heath a little behind her. It's a slower rundown, but she'll take the defender on. Goes at her. There's Carly Lloyd, who looks inside, can't make the connection. Scotland again with it, and she'll dribble out of bounds. Tobin Heath with the throw inside. It's Cheney. She's letting it ride to the penalty, to the goal box. Tries to play it back. Now a tackle by Scotland, and Scotland will be able to come out. Although numbers are not in their favor, it's a 2v4 situation. A little help now on the outside. The United States still with numbers behind the ball. It's Lisa Evans dropping for the goal scorer, Kim Little. She tries to go far post. It's cleared away. But not out, but Averbush will come on with the next ball. Kristen Lewis is on that defensive side. This is Sydney LaRue. Able to go around the defender. She'll get run off the ball. It will be probably a card. A bit of a hip check as LaRue was beyond the defender. That'll go to Rhonda Jones, number two. Mentioned Joanne Love. Two cautions in the game, both of them to Scotland. That one was more of the professional runner off. Or the one to Love was in the first half when she stepped on the ankle of Alex Morgan. I want to keep tuned to USsoccer.com to find out the latest on Alex's injury. They're going to evaluate that after the game. But this will bring a three-man wall This will bring Carly Lloyd and Averbush over it. Lloyd looks to be setting this one up. She'll set it up on the right foot. She'll rip it into the wall. Averbush on the rebound. Will send this one over the bar, and it will be a goal kick. So Jenna Fay's goal kick. The U.S. takes possession towards midfield. As this one goes over the end line, it will be a corner kick for Scotland. And looking down to the sideline, we already saw one young lady get her first cap as a U.S. player, and she made the most of it, Kristen Press. Also, Christy Mewis gets her first one. We could be seeing our third as well in Julie Johnston. This one grabbed by Nicole Barnhart off the corner kick. Nice job. Now she'll hit the drop kick to see if she can connect with Sydney LaRue. LaRue, one, two defenders on her, and the Scotland defender is able to get it away and come back the other way, offside position, so she's not going to go for it. That's Lisa Evans, and will find her way back to Barnhart. Those in the younger generation know that as letting the play go. Years ago, that would have been stopped, blowing a whistle, and now he just want to continue the play as Evans made no effort at the ball, even though she was offsides. Carly Lloyd tries to run on this one, and it's cleared out of bounds, and this might bring a couple of more substitutions for Scotland. It will. Off will be Joanne Love, and on will be Joelle Murray. That's the first sub. And then Rachel Small will be coming off, and on will be Frankie Brown. So five of the six subs now used by Scotland. And the sixth sub for the United States, and that will be Julie Johnston making her debut for Becky Sowerby. So now three United States players have earned their first cap. I'll give you those in a second, but Tobin Heath is going to try and find Krieger. Make that Lauren Chaney. Chaney will send it across the box. Tried to run onto LaRue. She does head it down. Now, nice effort, but not going to get wide, and Scotland will take away the ball. And that one will be a free kick for the United States. So as we mentioned, Christy Mewis, who came in as a substitute in the second half. You have also, as we mentioned, Kristen Press, who scored two goals, but now Julie Johnston, who was under 20 women's national team that won the World Cup for the United States last year, gets her first cap as well. Lloyd, down at her feet, will play it wide. Left foot across, it's going to go off. That's O'Hara, and off the Scottish player. It'll be a throw in for the United States. Julie Johnston. She'll work with Christy Rampone. Free kick for Scotland. Two central defenders right now, Christy Rampone And Julie Johnston, nearly 17 years difference in age. 16 years old was Rampone when Johnston was born. Johnston is the youngest player on the 18 roster. A couple younger there on the training camp roster, but getting her opportunity. Krieger, short for Carly Lloyd, but Scotland will get the steal and will counter. Final few minutes of this one, the United States leading 3-1. Sent across, flipped on, and Barnhart has to make a great save. Nice effort there by Jane Ross for Scotland, who was able to flick it on. Barnhart was making the effort towards the center of the net, had to go back to her near post and kept this a two-goal game. Otherwise, it could have been very interesting here in the last few minutes. But a great save by Nicole Barnhart. It's a corner kick for Scotland, and they'll play it short. Ball sent across, headed away, and then taken away. Lauren Cheney will look to just send it long. She does. The U.S. presses out from their own end. Scotland chases it down. Played wide. Good job defending by Krieger. She'll get it back at her feet. Johnston looks forward. Good work by the United States. It's Christine Lewis with a nice ball in. A nice tackle by Scotland. Fans wanted a call. Sydney LaRue went flying, but nothing doing by the referee. And the sixth sub for Scotland and the final sub coming on the game. Suzanne Grant will make her way on for Jane Ross, who just had that dangerous opportunity for Scotland. Final 3 minutes on the clock, plus any additional stoppage time. United States in again, the flip over, and there's the fourth goal for the U.S. Sydney LaRue looks to be the one. She came on, and as Jemma Faye came out, she was able to pin it by her. And the United States leads 4-1. Great long ball, and LaRue came on and just quickly, neatly, touched it into the back of the net. Lauren Cheney would have been there should she have been needed. So a 4-1 lead here in the final minutes here at Everbank Field. Bush was able to get that. Averbush was able to get the assist on that nice long ball. Scotland tries a long ball of their own, but Allie Krieger able to head that one away. They'll try and play into the corner still, and this one will go out of bounds for a throw-in for the United States. Krieger will take it. Still in play. Scotland tries to maintain possession. And they'll play it off at the U.S. So Scotland keeps possession. They'll play it long to Jemma Faye. Sydney LaRue, who's revitalized after that goal. Not really revitalized as a second half sub, but or actually she came on the last couple minutes of the first half, but really given a good chase. And the United States will get a throw in out of this. 90th minute on the clock. Stoppage time. Throw in the U.S. And the United States looks to switch the field. Cutting inside. Now played across as Fay will punch it out to the penalty spot. And Scotland's second one clears it out via throw in. LaRue drops it short. It's now to the feet of Chaney, but she can't send it wide. One minute of added time. We'll be over here shortly as the United States heads it back forward. Throw in Scotland. Again, LaRue with another opportunity. This one's played into the corner. She runs on to it, cuts it back with the right foot, looks to send it across. Couple of players there, but these are the blue shirts of Scotland, and they will get it out, but not away as Averbush comes down and being called for the fouls. LaRue, who comes in a little bit aggressively from the corner on the rebound. Sure to stick with us for the Budweiser Woman of the Match. The interview will be coming up shortly, and it'll be shorter than we thought because this one is over, and the United States in the first game under the new head coach, Tom Sermani, will get a 4-1 victory against Scotland here at Jacksonville tonight. And a couple of goals by Kristen Press, and then one each by Sydney LaRue and Shannon Box. And that gives you the four goals. Kim Little for Scotland got that one as well. So nice result here on Tom Sermani's first night. A reminder that these same two teams will be playing again on Wednesday night in Nashville. And they'll get an opportunity. We'll see what the results there. Of course, you can always watch that on ussoccer.com, as that's where all the action you can catch throughout the highlights. Again, we're waiting on the Budweiser Woman of the Match. Speculate, but why speculate? But we'll get that officially in just a couple of minutes. Of course, a couple of other things. Alex Morgan, who was averaging 84 minutes on the field per goal, you know, had to leave in the first half. We'll keep our eyes on what that injury may be. As we mentioned, it was a hard knock on the ankle, and we'll see. While that will be evaluated tomorrow. Algarve Cup will be coming up in Portugal next month, and the United States is gearing up for that. We talked a little bit about those upcoming games. Iceland, the People's Republic of China, and Sweden. One other game on the schedule right now coming up is going to be against Germany on April 5th. So again, we'll keep our eyes down on the sideline as or find out whether or not we'll get that Budweiser Woman of the Match, which I'm sure we will. Tom Sermani is making his way over there too. Looks like it's going to be Kristen Press. No surprise there. So I guess Aaron will be ready and we'll go to him in just a moment.
And you said,
So the player, the Budweiser woman of the match is Kristen Press. That might be a new trend here. If Aaron interviews him before the game, heck, why not? Let him be the star of the game, and a nice two goals in her first cap. Great crowd here in Jacksonville tonight. Post-match highlights are coming up. My thanks to Dave Keeble for all his help. I'm Mike Pepper. Enjoy it, USSoccer.com. Get those highlights. Find out all the news coming up on Wednesday night. The next one, the U.S. versus Scotland from Nashville. Good night, everyone. Thank you.